All right, YouTube, what is up? It's been a while since I've done a video. Got nothing really new to review lately, so I do got two things, but I'll get to them when I get to them. But for now, I was going to do a quick 2014 knife collection update, if you will. Just a rundown of what I got. I got some good stuff, some really crappy stuff, and stuff in between, some fun stuff. So if you're bored, like I am at 1 a.m. on a Saturday night, the night before the Super Bowl in January 2014, enjoy, and we'll run through this. So you get to look at my awesome camouflage little setup I got. So first knife, we'll start off with, I'll start off with some my better stuff. That way, if you want to stop it whenever you want, you don't have to sit through this entire video to look at the good stuff. Most people start off with their crappy stuff or, you know, whatever. But I'll give you the good stuff first. How's that? So we'll go with the crown jewel of my, what I think my collection is, and that is my Strider SMF. This is an awesome knife. I've had this, I think I got this like last spring or last summer, 2013, and this thing is badass. It's a big, blocky knife. I did a review on it. You can check that out. Check my channel out. Great knife overall. CPMS 30V. My camera's not the greatest, so bear with me here. Made in the U.S. That's why I love it. It's U.S. made. Solid titanium frame lock. Really solid piece of G10 here. And look at that. The blade stock is just absurd. But yeah, it's a great knife. I'll just put them up here, and we'll go down the list here. All right, next up we got probably my favorite everyday knife. This thing is the Spyderco Paramilitary 2. And I'd say about 95% of the time, this is what's in my pocket. It's light. It is extremely sharp. I've actually had to resharpen it a couple times, used it so much. But this coating is perfect. I've never seen a coating hold up like this one has. And it's got the compression lock and all that. You can, you know, flick it out like that. Whatever. This is my go-to knife when I got nothing else to go to. And it's got the ACU camouflage pattern. This is the Army. If anyone knows my channel, I was in the Marines, so if they ever made this in MARPAT, that would be the shit. So, Spyderco, if you're watching, you know, hey, throw us a sprint run of MARPAT. I'll buy 5 of them, guaranteed. So, that is my definite everyday. And these first 3 knives, actually, will be my, they are my go-to knives that I go to. I rotate in and out. They're my top 3 that I use all the time. So the third one will be the Spyderco Manix 2. I tried to spray paint this when I got first into knives. I didn't know what I was doing. And actually this backspacer comes gray or silver, I forget. But I spray painted it black and it's held up. And I actually like it like that. So, you know, play around your knives. If you don't mind messing them up here and then. I actually spray painted these liners and I just took that off and it looks just fine. This is a great knife too. Again, US made 154 cm steel, and I wasn't a fan of these serrations at first, but I've actually come to like them a lot. If I can, I don't mind them so much, but I do prefer the plain edge, but if it's Spyderco's edge, I don't mind at all. So great knife. Oh, that was a bad deployment there. Anyway, moving on. I'll try to keep the camera focused on these knives if possible. I have one hand doing this, so bear with me, people. All right. Then we got the Spyderco Goddard. This is a sprint run, and I don't use this one as much. Oh, God, I can't flick them out tonight. I don't use this one. I like it a lot. It's an olive drab. I love this color. I did a review on this one too, and this thing is sharp. VG10, made in Japan, but this is probably the sharpest knife in my entire collection. Just a great knife overall. Real lightweight. I just don't want to carry it. I carry this when I go out to like a dinner or someplace where I know I'm not going to hard use it or whatever, you know, light cutting. I mean, I probably could do more with it, but I just don't want to. I just like it too much. It really is a great knife. You know, lock back, you know, flick it down. You can salute it one hand, even though it is a lock back. There's a good deployment. So, you know, pin construction, can't take it apart. That's another reason I don't want to get all that crap in there. And I limitly carry that one. All right. You'll notice I talk more about the knives I really like. And you see the ones coming up, and I don't as much. So, all right, here we go. Another one. Another Spyderco. How about that? You can see I'm a Spyderco fan. Not going to lie. Everyone who's got a knife collection probably has, or especially a Spyderco collection, has one of these. This is the Tenacious. Again, these G10 scales came black. I spray painted them. I also spray painted the inside liners and the clip, which I regret, just like the Mannix 2. I wish I didn't do that, but you live and you learn, and these were my first knives, folding knives, that really got me into it. I have a couple other knives that were folding, but I really didn't care for collecting knives at the time. But this thing is sharp. And, I was going to redo a review on it, but everyone and their mom has a review on one of these, so. Just like the next one coming up. Everyone has a review on it, even myself. And that is the Ontario Rat 1. And this thing flies out. I can't believe how this thing flies out. Manual. I just love the Coyote Brown scales. These are the Zytel, or I don't even know what they are. They're plastic. They're not G10. But again, this is another type of shallow scalped serrations that I like, and this knife came sharp. Aus-8, you know, overseas produced, kind of heavy for what it is, but I think they came out with a new one, the Rat Model 2. It's supposed to be a little bit smaller than this, but I carry this one every now and then. This one's fun to carry. I just like flicking this thing out. This thing is fast. I had knives that, you know, are assisted, and they don't come out as fast as this one. And this is manual. I did have another one that was the satin finish blade with the olive drab. I think I sold that on eBay. I didn't like the color of the olive drab. I like this color and a couple other colors you'll see coming up. That was kind of late for me. But yeah, Ontario Rat 1. Everyone's got one of these, right? So I'll try to keep the camera over here as I reach over. And here we go. A little cold steel. AK-47. I love this knife. Again, spray painted these G10 scales, but they actually held up. You know, you take the whole knife apart, and they actually held up. Back spacer on this thing is wicked. You know, lanyard hole, pointed, you know, non-lethal defense if you had to. This thing is big, and this thing waves off, and I didn't take that off myself. Well, I did, but that paint came off. I have a review on this knife, too. Check that out. You know, this thing waves off your pocket. I love the blade shape. The blade shape on this thing is nasty. I just love how that belly just sweeps in there. You can do whatever you want to do. And the grip, you know, it has no jimping. Well, if you want to call that jimping. But, I mean, the G10 is so aggressive, and this thing locks in. And, you know, even reverse grip, this thing fits perfect. So, and it comes with a couple of pocket clips, but I took those screws out. I don't know why. But, pretty good blade. I love this one too. Actually, I like all my knives. Oh, I can't say that. I like most of my knives. Alright, here we go. With the, this was the first folder I got that started my collection years ago. I just got this one because it was the cheapest one. I just wanted something small. I don't even know if I can do this with my left hand. Oh, barely. But, yep, CRK TM1610KZ. It's a mouthful, right? You know, Zytel handles real light on this thing. This is the M16 EDC version with the auto locks. Really great little knife. I probably carry this one. I do carry this every day in the wintertime because the jacket I wear for work has a pocket in the arm, and this one is so light. I put it in there just as a backup. You know, Tonto blade with the serrations. I don't care for these serrations too much, but I think this is HCR 13 MOV steel, which is okay. It dulls quick, but sharpens real easy. So I just keep this one there. And everyone had always, I've seen reviews where they complain about the auto locks. It takes two hands. No, it doesn't. Watch. One hand. Oh, how about that? Now it doesn't want to flick out. I can't flick tonight. This knife is a pain in the ass. But, the detail on this one, for some reason, came real stiff. I could not get this thing out. So I took it apart and sanded it down a little bit, just loosened it up. It's done the job, but, or it doesn't click like I want it to, but it was, I think I paid $20, $15 for this thing. Great little knife, compared to, the other one's small, but it does the job. So that's a CRKT. Next up, I carry this one. I go out to like a nice restaurant or, I live in a state where, you pull out something like that and, everyone's, oh my God, you're going to kill little babies. Yeah, whatever. I live in New Jersey, so everyone's all scared of, they're scared of their own shadow. But this is I consider this my gentleman's knife. This is the Buck Vantage Paper Stone. This is the small one. It's got a deep pocket clip. When people see this clip, they just think it's a pen or something, not a knife. And even when you do bust this knife out, no one's scared of it. I actually jimped out myself with the Dremel tool. And this one was pretty cheap. I think I got this on an REI. I don't know. But this is that paper stone scales. The lighting in my apartment is horrible, so I'm sorry for that. But this is actually like a nice, real nice blue, bluish green that's made out of recycled paper. And resin or something. So that's a good, that's a real good EDC blade, stainless steel liners stuff. I got that little flipper. You can deploy it in there if you really dig your thumb. I don't even know if I can do it. I can't do it. Thumb's too big, but the flipper flies right out. So, all right, let's see what's up next. Oh, here we go. I just got this Christmas. My dad actually got me this. This is one of those knives you pick up at Things Remember and you get it engraved. It does have my name on the clip, so I'm trying not to show that too much. I don't really care, but whatever. These are one of those. I like the knife. I like the, it's heavy. And it's got a lot of features. It's got the seatbelt cutter and a glass breaker there. But it had a thumb disc up here, like those Emerson's, a round thumb disc. That broke right off, so I just have to kind of, Got that spear point blade, a little swedge up top, unsharpened. But it's pretty sharp. It's actually not a bad knife. It actually feels comfortable in hand. It's big enough I can hold it. And the blade shape is good. And it doesn't have any blade play when I play with it. I flip my knives. But anyway, it is good. I just wish it didn't have a broken thumb thing on there. So I'll have to figure that out later on. So I'm trying to give you guys a point on the knives that you would enjoy the porn. Now this is one of those little... If anyone stays up late at night and watches at 5 in the morning like I do, you catch that Cutlery Corner type show. Some guy at my work actually bought a lot of these knives and was selling them. I just picked these up because he was selling them for $1 each. And, I can't resist a bladed, an edged weapon or an edged tool of any kind. So I got this. Is that Whitetail Cutlery, a little division of that Frost Cutlery. I just like the blade shape. I don't carry this one. I don't do anything with it, really. But I just wish it had better materials or was made by a company that knew how to make knives. Because this little shape is great. I mean, I just wish it was made better, that's all. I mean, it's real flimsy. But anyway, got to get rock and rolling here. Moving on to cheaper stuff as far as folders go. Well, not really folders, but... I do got, I guess, one Balisong that I flip around. This one's real cheap. I don't even know what this is. It's flimsy, and this is one I sit with TV and watch TV and flip around just for shits and giggles. I don't really use this one at all. Being that I live in New Jersey, again, this is a, a thug's weapon or whatever. Yeah. All right, next up is one of those real cheap. Another one from that Frost Cutlery crap. This one is so horrible. I don't even want to show it, but it's just comical. The pocket clip is a joke. I don't even know, but you can literally just shake this thing out if you wanted to. You don't need a flipper. I doubt the lock locking mechanism will even hold up to anything. So look, I'm just going to go, and it comes out. I didn't do anything, I just held it. You know, it's really bad. It's only got even one steel liner, look. One steel liner, these aren't even like G10, these are straight up plastic. So, just a cheap knife I have in there. This next one I got as a gift. Yeah, I'm a Packers fan, so someone gave this to me. It's, you know, a lockback. Just a cheap knife I got. Some time down the road there, you know, you open up your drawer and bam, you got a knife. This is one of those knives I picked up at a gun show. And it's one of those cheesy Chinese made. I want to get the spider on there, and it's spring assisted actually. It's pretty cool, but the serrations suck. It's not sharp. It doesn't have any. It has side to side play, up down. It's cheaply made, but it's a fun. It's quick. It works. All right, moving on. What do we got? We got just a cheap folder. You know, Vietnam commemorative type thing I got when I was little. I kept it, and there it is. Not much to say. This next one, my mom actually got for me, just randomly. One of them little bullet knives. Let's see if I can do this with two hands. Okay, there we go. Yeah. Just a little bullet knife. It's shaped like a 30-06 bullet. Even it says 30-06 on there. And it's got a little blade. Yeah, it's fun. Little novelty type blades. And you got your, you know, your Victorinox thing. It's got a little... A little light on it. Yeah, I'm not gonna open them up. You know what they all look like. And another little knife, corkscrew, and all that fun stuff. This one I keep on my keychain all the time. The Spyderco. This is the Honeybee. I love this little thing. This little thing has gotten me out of more jams and little things to cut here and there. It's a great one. This is one of those, I guess, card sharp ones. You fold it up, put it in your wallet. This thing's fun. I actually just got this. I don't know if it's that brand at Sinclair or whatever it is, but it works, and I like it. I keep it in my wallet. So this one's just a cheap one my brother got me. I don't know if it's cheap, but I don't really know what it is. It does this whole rigmarole of a thing there. It covers a blade, sort of, and you have the saw. I got nothing on that. This one is particularly special. This is a Kershaw Amphibian. I got back in 2000, and this is a war knife for me. I had this on my flat jacket while serving in Iraq. Great knife, MRE opener, everything else. Good times, bad times with this blade. With two more that I'm going to show you, actually went to war with me. One of my favorites there, as a fixed blade. This is one of those Frost Cutlery ones I got for cheap. I spray painted the handles myself, spray painted the blade. Actually came out pretty good. It's a cheap knife, I got it for $1, and I customized it myself. So not much to say about that one. Alright, we're going to fixed blades. Or you know what, we'll do the multi-tools. How's that? I got the Leatherman S2 Juice. I carry this every day. Great little blade on this. Let's see if I can open it up with one hand or two hands here. Great little EDC thing, lightweight. Yeah, I got the little lanyard on it. So we'll put that up there. I got a little collection going on. Next one I carry on myself every day as well, on my belt, because it's a medium sized, is the Leatherman rebar. Now I love this thing. This thing is great. I probably use this at least once a day for something. I had a knife. This is one of the ones I'm going to do a review on in a little bit, so stay tuned for that. Along with its other one is the Leatherman Mutt military utility tool. That's what it's called, right? Yeah. But this one's got the, you know, the saw there on the outside, blade there. This one's AR-15 M16 specific. So I do have an AR-15 type rifle, so I'm waiting to get that shot up. So I can, you know, do some shooting with that, and then use this. Show you how it cleans. This thing is a great heavy-duty multi-tool, especially in the military. So we'll continue on here. All right, on to fixed blades. We'll start with the cheapest ones first. All right. So I got this one when I was, probably 10 years old. one of those cheap survival knives, stainless steel blade, made in China, probably. He's got the survival kit and a handle. I wrapped this myself. Spray painted the blade. It used to be silver. Whoop-de-doo, right? He's got the saw back. No one really carries this thing. I wouldn't carry it in the combat. It'd probably fall apart. Next up is my Ontario Marine fighting knife, also known, you know, everyone calls them K-Bars, but K-Bars is a specific brand. Ontario makes them too. So, yeah, I've had this one since probably high school, and, you know, classic design. I love it. So, I'm sorry, stacking knives on top of knives. I'm running out of room. The next one is, and I had this one since high school too. This is just an M1 Garand bayonet. It probably needs some work. It's a little bit rusty. It's old. I do have an M1 on the wall, which does shoot and fire, and I love that rifle. But this does fit on it, and every now and then I'll bust it out just to mess around, if you know what I mean. Next up is my stepdad actually gave me this because he figured I would appreciate it. It is a Camillus U.S. Navy Mark I. Don't even think they make these anymore. Leather stacked, great little short knife. It's almost like the Marine K-Bar, but really shorter. And being Camillus, you know, this thing, I think it was made in the 40s or something like that. But great little knife. I don't use it, obviously, because I just like to preserve it. But, yep, cool little knife. Cool fixed blade knife. I like. Man, got a lot of knives. Run out of room here. Next up is another war blade that went with me to Iraq, and this is the Ontario M9 bayonet. I actually did keep this on my side. Being a Marine, they didn't issue these to us. I actually bought this myself. Yeah, that actually looks like a bear's face, huh? Yeah, you got the mouth eyes. Yeah, haha. Anyway, I wrapped this myself in a gutted 550 cord a long time ago, and this went to Iraq with me. Like I said, they issued us those cheesy bayonets. I just did not like. I wanted something bigger. I was like, if I was going to go to war, I wanted something substantial. And I got this years before I before 9/11 even happened. And this did go to Iraq with me. So again, this is another war blade that has some sentimental value to me, and probably will with my children someday. My third war blade, yeah. you're seeing a theme here, Ontario. Ontario Spec Plus Survival SP5-95. This thing also went to war with me, another war blade. This one was on my flak jacket next to the Kershaw Amphibian. And this is a great survival knife. I've split logs with this thing. This is it's just a great, you know, all around, in between a fighting knife and a machete. It's that perfect in-between, real thick blade stock on that. I've tested it out myself, and it's seen combat, so it's a veteran like myself. All right, what's up? Oh, technically this is a war blade, but not mine. This was given to me by my stepdad as well. This is a Arasaka bayonet from Okinawa, from the Battle of Okinawa in 1945. My stepdad's uncle actually picked this up off the ground from, I'm assuming, a Japanese soldier of some kind. Thought I would appreciate it, being a Marine. I've been to Okinawa for 6 months, so I've been there, and I do appreciate this. This is a real war blade. You know, there's a serial number on it. I think this was made in Seki City, Japan. And I can look up the serial number. So it's got some history to it. What else? Oh, here we go. This is just a SOG Fast Hawk. I actually bought this just for fun, and I literally threw it at a tree for the first time, and it stuck dead on. I couldn't believe it. I wrapped this myself. I do a lot of riding with you know, stuff. I haven't really used this out in camping or whatever. So there's that. Another one is another war blade. Again, not mine. This was also picked up by my stepfather's uncle on the island of Okinawa. And this is a Japanese NCO sword. And it is very real. There's serial numbers, and it's got a wooden, handmade wooden handle. I think one of these things had broken off. I mean, he picked this thing up in 1945. I don't have the official scabbard to it, which I wish I did. But it is a important blade to me. It definitely means a lot. So, not too many. You don't really see too many swords on these knife collections. But yeah, it's pretty neat. Pretty neat stuff. It's a blade I enjoy. I keep these two on my wall. Really appreciate them. So. That's most of my knife. That's pretty much all my knife collection. Just some little doodads here and there since I got some time left. Smith & Wesson tactical pen. I use this every single day. Every day I do a lot of writing. So I do use that. I just got two 4.7s. These are the old mini 1.23s, and I call them the mini MLs. I somehow acquired two of them, but these things are great. You know, I picked some of these up. Real easy to use. And just for fun, I picked this up at a Renaissance fair for $10, and you guys are going to laugh. Well, I laughed when I saw it. That's why I bought it. So, you hear it clunk open, and this is one of those ridiculous pocket knives that actually does fold, and this thing is hilarious. I get more laughs out of this thing than anything. It is a locking, actual lockback folding knife. It's got the cheesy, you know, gold dragon on it. All that fun stuff with the dragon on there, you know, stainless steel and China, you know. It's just funny. I mean, look at it next to the CRKT. No comparison. It just cracks me up. But it does fold, and it, you know, got the big lock back here. And then bring that down. I'm trying to do this one-handed. I'm trying not to lob an arm off. But, yeah. Let's see if I can flick it open. Okay. So, yep, that's it. That's all I got. So, hope you guys enjoyed. Sorry I'm going to make more videos. You're going to get a review on these two, I'd say, hopefully, in the next couple months. Definitely this one. If I get out with the AR sooner, I will get both of them done at the same time. So, if you guys have any questions, comments, leave them. Subscribe. I don't care. I'm just doing this for fun because, again, it's almost 1:30 in the morning, and I thought it would be fun to show off a little bit of knife collection. All right. Y'all have a good night. Peace.